Hello, I'm Rob Byron, product manager at Vaddio, and I'm here to talk to you guys real quick about the Vaddio Deployment Tool 1.1.0 update and the overview of the product in general. So let's go ahead and first show you, where do you get this? So go to legrandav.com, click on Vaddio, go to Tools, Deployment Tool, download now, and you'll have to fill out this form to be able to download it. But then you can install Deployment Tool. And what is Deployment Tool? So Deployment Tool is a tool that allows you to discover Vaddio devices, manage them, give them firmware updates, do general configuration management, general troubleshooting, and really just makes installation a lot easier, especially with network products such as our new Easy IP system. So that makes it easy to find all your devices. So once you download the application and install it, you just have to run it, and you should have something that looks approximately like this. So you go ahead and click Find Devices, scan your local network, and a bunch of devices should start popping up, assuming you're plugged into the same network. So you gotta make sure that you are on the same network like I am. So I know that the camera next to me is an Easy IP camera, and hey look, there's only one camera that was discovered that was an Easy IP. So there are a couple things you can do from this interface. I won't go highly into detail in this video, but just show you a couple of the easy things. So be able to go to the device webpage, just to show you that this is in fact the camera right next to me. And I am able to steer it around. Look at that. I can control the camera and it found the camera right next to me. So I can do some other things. I have the capacity to firmware update all of the devices I so choose. So you can actually do mass firmware updates. I can select all these devices and do a mass firmware update. Install latest firmware. That would bring all of my system up to the latest firmware, which is a great little feature. Or I can select an individual device to update. So I can go to this one link that says there's new firmware available, and I really want to upgrade it to 1.2.1, and I can click install. And that'll go ahead and install the firmware on that. So first it downloads it from our servers and pushes it up there to the one link and gives it the new firmware. And it'll notify me later that that has succeeded. I also have the capacity to do other functions. So if I wanted to, calibrate the camera or reboot it, let's say it was misbehaving and a customer reported an issue, I can go ahead and reboot the device. And that's going to turn it off. I also can group my devices. So let's say I really wanted to group all of my robo shots together. So go into RoboShot, add and remove devices. So let's filter against everything that's a RoboShot. Wow, look at that. Now I can add all of those devices to a group I've called RoboShot. And now I can independently manage all my RoboShots. So you could do things like manage room, manage particular buildings in the university, things of that nature, which are fairly convenient. You can look at your scan history and figure out what kind of scans you've done, which subnets you have accessed. You can actually export device data. So that's one of the neat features. So you can go in here and you can actually do a mass backup of all your configurations. So if I wanted to make sure that all these devices had a known good state, I can go in and I can export data. So that, well, a couple it couldn't do because I was rebooting them. It'll export all that data. And when you go into here, you have all of your configuration data exported as a backup. So you have a golden copy that you can always reapply back to your device. You also have a little bit of a log. So if you wanted to see what you had done, so I did a data export, I rebooted this device, I installed firmware on this device, you know what has been done to those devices from your group. Workspaces is really if you're doing multiple installations and you're installing, you know, one university and then a different university, kind of like you wouldn't keep all your data in one Excel file, you wouldn't want to keep all of your installation data in one workspace. So you can create new workspaces and separate your devices at a higher level like that. And then the system information, this is just some basic information about the application itself, a little bit of help in case you need a little bit more information as opposed to this video. And of course, very important to us is the feedback. So if you want to be able to send us feedback, there's a form you can fill out just by clicking on here, and that'll come directly to my team. and will allow us to know how to improve the application. Speaking of improvements, new with 1.1 is the capacity to do mass export of data. So you'll see this export Excel feature in the workspace section. So if I click on that, it'll go ahead and export all of this in all of the scanned devices in this workspace out to an Excel file, which then allows me to get information such as device serial number in the future. We'll get to that later. Get MAC address, host name, IP address, groups it's a part of, the type of device it is, whether it's on the latest firmware or not, things of that nature. So you can actually use this sort of as an installation report to hand off to customers, and it's a very valuable feature for those reasons. And it doesn't take a lot of effort to generate one. Other improvements is we did Cider scanning, as a couple of people had pointed out, which is just an advanced way of scanning networks. So that allows you to scan using syntax you're familiar with. And we did the mass export. You can also change now login information. So if you have corporate compliance that forces you to change every 30 to 60 days or something like that, you can change the passwords of those devices, which is you can also log into them. So if you change the passwords and somebody doesn't know that, you can actually do a mass login of information, as well as a mass change of password. So if I wanted to change the password of my installation, I would do that just by entering the two passwords in here, and then everything would be different. But people are using these devices, and I don't want to do that right now. So this has been a pretty quick update of deployment tool and the updates to it. So hopefully this has been useful for you.